Good morning and welcome to Saturday Disney. Hello.
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 Hey, good morning.
Hey, we are so fortunate. You know why?
Why is that?
Because it's a weekend and we can do whatever we want.
Of course, we could have adventures, we could play golf, we could play cricket, we could play basketball, or we could just sit around and watch cartoons with us.
Sounds good. I like the cartoons.
What else have you got for us, Tim?
Well, today we have golf, young Greg Norman, and we have Cherry. Lovely new band, and we also have biodiversity being shown to us by a very strange scientist indeed.
What on earth is biodiversity?
Tim, where's the milk?
We don't have any, but we don't need any. Come sit down.
Oh, really? I don't need any. How am I supposed to eat my cereal without milk?
Well, I've got a little challenge for you today. You've got to eat one of those dry cereal biscuits in under 15 seconds without fluid.
That's easy. Once I finish doing that, can you set me a real challenge?
Yep, your time starts.
Yeah, thanks.
Now. How'd you go?
Pretty well, I think. I'm almost finished, but I'm definitely higher.
Well, because we can't understand what Mel's saying today, we're going to go under the sea to Atlantica and see the evil manta.
I think that's a great idea. Atlantica.
Oh, I wonder what havoc the evil manta is going to inflict upon Atlantica.
Yes, I think it might be a little hot under the collar. The volcano thing breaking.
Yes.
Perfect, thank you.
All right.
Do you need milk?
No, we don't, but it's all right because I've got a task for you, which I set for Mel earlier. You're going to eat one of these in under 15 seconds without milk.
Are you kidding me?
No.
Oh,
okay, ready? You ready?
No,
your time starts now.
Oh!
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Not too easy, is it? So you can gobble on that while we go to a break, I think.
Have you got enough milk there, Tim?
Milk?
Yeah?
Surprise!
I've got enough milk.
Well, you don't seem to have enough cereal biscuits. So Mel and I have a challenge for you. No time limit. You can sit here all day if you like until you've finished all your breakfast.
All right.
Your time starts now. I think Tim's in trouble and so is Atlantica. Let's see whether Ariel can warn them of the evil manta.
Come on. We don't want to be here all day.
Don't worry, Tim, you're doing very well. Better than Ariel is anyway. I'm a little bit worried about what the evil manta is planning to do with her.
Tim, have you ever heard the expression, do unto others as you would have them do unto you?
Yes, well, there's a lesson in that for all of us.
There is. Don't worry, things are looking up. Craft is next.
Oh, good.
It's time for craft, and it's a messy kind of morning this morning. So, in order to do this, I've laid down some newspaper so I don't ruin anything. We're going to be making plaster molds. This is kind of what they look like when they've finished. They've been finished, depending on how you decorate them. This one has been decorated by using a starfish to imprint. But you can use shells or glass beads or whatever you can possibly think of. Now, what we're going to use this morning is simply our hand to make a mould into the plaster. What we need to do that is a bucket, we need some pottery plaster and some water. So the first thing you need to do is pour some pottery plaster into the bucket. I'm going to use all of what I have in here. And then you slowly add water so you don't add too much. If you add it all straight away, you might have a problem. So, slowly adding the water, you start to mould or mix the plaster with the water until you get a consistency which is a bit like toothpaste. Now I need heaps more water actually. This is very messy. Alright, so once you've got a consistency like toothpaste, You can then start to imprint, but I think I need to mix this for a little bit longer. And once I've mixed it and put my hand into the plaster, I need to wait 20 minutes. So all this is going to happen while you go, guys, go under the sea. I'm glad everyone's friends again, because Atlantica just wouldn't be the same without the singing and dancing. Well, I've conducted my plaster experiment at the barbecue and I've reached a decent consistency with my plaster and water. So all I need to do now is to press my hand firmly into the plaster so I get a nice handprint. This bucket is a bit small for my hand. I could have used a bigger one, so make sure that when you're doing this, your hand fits nicely into the bucket. And leave your hand there a couple of seconds so that when you take it out, you get a nice handprint like so. So now what we need to do is wait 20 minutes until the plaster sets enough for us to take it out of the bucket. So you guys go to a break and we'll see you soon. Had a plaster disaster, but not quite.
How's it going?
Good. What are you guys up to?
I'm reading a choose your own adventure book.
And I'm shuffling cards. So if anyone's up for a game, I'm almost ready.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Choose your own adventure.
Yeah.
Hey, I've got an adventure for both of you.
Do
what
you?
Is that?
One of our favourite cartoons. Doug's just about to start. This week is Doug is in debt.
Doug has lost his hat, but luckily not his head. He's being very controlled, don't you think?
Very controlled, considering his sister's going to hand down some severe punishment, like you guys did to me before with that cereal biscuit.
Oh, and whose fault was that? Wasn't it your challenge in the first place? Hey, I've got an adventure for you.
What?
You know, you're reading your book.
Yeah?
Yes, well, there's an adventure happening in your room.
Really?
It's a mountain of clothes that I believe has a place in your cupboard.
If you can get in the door.
Off you go. Right. Go! Yeah. Get to it.
Fun, snappy. Fun, fun. Good luck.
We'll see you after the break.
I'm Nathan, and this is my dad.
Hi, everyone.
And we love playing golf together. Golf is a game where you use a golf club and a ball, and you have to try and get in the hole. I've been playing golf for a year and a half, and my dad got me interested when he became a golf professional. My dad works at the pro shop. It's really good because I can come out here and practice when I want. There are different clubs for hitting from different places. This is a driver where you hit off a tee, and this is a putter where you putt on a green. When you're teeing off, you try and hit as far as you can and straight as you can. I play with my dad a lot and I try and beat him each hole, but he's too good, I can't beat him.
Good drive, no? What number is your ball?
Three. You hooked yours, I think.
Yeah, I think I'm in the bunker up there. You look like you're down the middle of the fairway, though. Mm-hmm. Should be an easy second for you.
Should make 30. There are a lot of water hazards and sand bunkers, and if your ball goes in one of them, you're in trouble. I would like to become a professional golfer and play on the US circuit when I'm older. Greg Norman is my favourite professional golf player, because he's won a lot of tournaments and he's ranked number one in the world. When you're putting, you have to line up your putt and pick the right speed and it'll go in, hopefully.
Good shot, Nathan. Well played.
I like playing golf because I like playing with all my mates and it's a lot of fun.
Well, Nathan may not be as good as his dad yet, but guaranteed he'll be playing with the likes of Greg Norman in the future. Guys, now we are going to Doug to see if he's had any luck finding his sister's hat. Somehow, I don't think so.
Buy more butter!
You don't see that every day, do you? A cow on skates reminds me of a hippo way skating, or what? A giraffe doing limbo, guys?
Hey, why are you sitting over there and we're doing all the work?
I scaled that mountain of clothes in my room. I ate all those cereal biscuits. I think I deserve a bit of a break.
Aww. Oh, really?
Very clever.
Why?
Because you know what's coming up after the break, don't you?
No, I don't.
Oh, well, you have to wait and see.
Hoya! Hoya!
It's about that time. That is time for Diz News. And today, it's all about martial arts. So without further ado, here it is.
Have you ever wondered where those amazing fighters you see in Chinese kung fu movies come from? How they learn their incredible moves? In China, martial arts are extremely popular, and there are many schools across the country where people train. However, there's one place where many of the very best begin, the Shaolin School in China's Penang province. Annie and Wilfred, hosts of the Disney Club in China, decided to see what it was like to train with students there. Boys and girls from 7 to 17 come from all over the country to this famous school. They train and study during the whole school year, dividing their time between kung fu and normal classroom subjects like history, maths, science, and Chinese literature. They're also taught a unique Chinese writing art called calligraphy. According to legend, modern kung fu began in the Shaolin Temple of Hunan about 1500 years ago. A wandering Buddhist priest came to the temple and found the monks in terrible shape. He taught them exercises to increase their stamina and to improve their health. He also taught the monks moves so they could protect themselves from bandits and armed invaders. In time, weapons techniques were also added to the Shaolin system. These days, students are taught throws, holds, punches, flying kicks, and weapons use. These exercises are performed thousands of times, gradually improving their technique. When students train to fight during class, the purpose of the training is to develop confidence and self-control, so that using such skills outside of school will be unnecessary. China's Shaolin fighters have long been famous as acrobats. They routinely perform incredible leaps and twists in the air. Students take their training and studies very seriously, which doesn't mean they don't have time for some fun every now and again. After training for several days, Wilfred thinks he's ready to take on one of the young masters. Wilfred is fast on his feet, but maybe not as serious as he needs to be. As their week at the Shaolin School comes to an end, Annie and Wilfred say goodbye to their new friends. They certainly won't forget their Shaolin experience or the valuable lesson they learned there. Never sacrifice studies for martial arts or other distractions, for even if you learn a skill, a tool with a dull edge is a dull tool of limited use.
That's very deep, isn't it? Well, how about we take a deep dive back into Doug?
You know,
what?
I think I'm a bit like Doug.
Why?
Because I'm really bad at basketball. Dong.
Yes.
And? I used to be a cub. Dibbity-dib. Dob-dob-dob.
Yes.
Blub-blub-blub. And I'm a really poor whistler.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, in fact, don't whistle. We've got some real singers coming up after the break. Cherry's joining us on the show.
Wouldn't you laugh?
I'm Hayley.
I'm Jerry.
I'm Camille. Yes, that's right. I never forget it.
And Jerry!
Wicked.
I don't want your money, honey. I want your love.
Really? Whose idea was the name Cherry?
We're just eating cherries we're and staying. Throwing them all in each other's mouths. And, like, we need a name. We're going through thesauruses and
dictionaries.
I've seen everything. Yeah, and then I can't remember who it was. One of us just said, "Oh, this guy sells cherries," and I went, "Cherry, why?" And then I think one of you said something about, "Oh, it's red," and I went, "Yeah, juicy," and we kept going on with everything that had to do with cherries.
Really silly.
Yeah, being silly. So there's Cherry.
Do you guys have any nicknames?
I'm just Camille.
I'm just Jerry. I call Jerry Jez sometimes.
And
Hails,
it's kind
just
of
short.
Aima?
Yeah.
Short.
Yeah. Aima's Hails.
Yeah. I
call
them all by
their
real names.
So do I.
I can't be bothered. And I hate nicknames. I don't want a nickname. I'm Camille, I'm Camille, I'm Camille.
Oh, what was your name again?
Camille.
Oh, okay.
How did you guys meet?
These three started off all together. They were sort of performing in a government-run project called Talent Development Project.
and which is run by the Department of Education.
And yeah, and then I knew Amy from dancing, and these two guys went to school together, and we all kind of got together through that. We all kind of knew each other, and yeah.
How long have you guys been together?
2 years now.
What do you like doing when you're not singing?
Jazzercising. Ames is a jazzercise instructor as well.
Yeah, so
we get in the studio and
exercise.
Yeah,
takes us
for
to
free.
Do some jazzercise.
We just
get together and turn on the
music
and have fun.
Amy, don't do this to me! Don't do this to me!
Can we stop?
No, we're
going to
keep
going. How much more to go, Ames?
Just another half
an hour. SOS. Your debut single, SOS, was a huge success. Can you please tell me a little about your latest release?
Your Love.
That's what it's called.
It's a cover of an old song. It's a cover of a Transvision Vamp song. It's about 10 years old, and it was a hit then, so we hope to make it a hit once again.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's fantastic.
It's fun. It's really it's a change from SOS. You know, it's like, it's a bit more edgy, and we're taking that little risk to come out a bit more.
It's really, really vamp it up on stage.
Yeah. Lots of good times. I want your love.
I have a little request. Can you please sing an a cappella version of one of your tracks for me?
Is that right?
Yeah, that sounds good.
2, 3.
SOS, I need someone to rescue me. SOS, this is an emergency. SOS, I need some L-O-V-E. Take my heart and save my soul.
I want your money, honey. I want your love.
Really?
You know what I think's nice is that they're all friends.
That is good.
Important? Yeah.
Very good. Chemistry
if they tour
is there.
And travel and all that sort of stuff. You need to be friends.
You
That's
do.
True. Hmm.
Ideas?
Yes.
Got one.
You know how we had such a delicious breakfast this morning.
Oh, indeed.
Why don't these guys out there make their parents breakfast during the break?
Ah, a better
That's
one.
A great one.
And no cooking. I repeat,
and don't
no
leave
cooking.
Yet. Don't leave just yet.
Okay.
The break's almost here, but wait for it.
Wait. Ready? Go!
Go! Do you know what? I wish I had superpowers like the genie on Aladdin, because if I did, I could make the postman come even quicker. Ah! You're too good to us, Posty. Thank you very much. Well, I may not have superpowers, but I do have the power to bring you Aladdin. This week, the Netherworld returns. And what secrets does it behold? You're about to see.
How loud can one bird be? I mean, Iago could squeak the ear off an elephant. So I hope he doesn't try. Here is a new competition for you.
The following exciting competition is proudly brought to you by Walt Disney's Mulan, now available on video.
Walt Disney's animated masterpiece, Mulan, is an enthralling and fun-filled adventure set against the vast and mysterious landscape of China. High-spirited Mulan defies tradition and disguises herself as a man to take her beloved father's place in the Imperial Army. With her hilarious guardian dragon, Mushu, by her side, Mulan proves to be a brave and disciplined warrior who brings honor to her family. You can now own your very own copy of Mulan on video. To celebrate, Walt Disney Home Video and Saturday Disney are teaming up to give little Aussie heroes the chance to win a holiday to China. There, they'll visit many of the sites which inspired the Disney animators in their research for Mulan. The search is on for Mulan's Australian family hero, a special child whose extraordinary spirit has brought pride and honour to their family through a simple act of kindness, a bold act of bravery, or a special act of loyalty. You can enter the competition yourself or have a member of your family or a friend nominate you. Each entry must be accompanied by a letter answering this question. What's the most important thing you've done for your family? The winner of Mulan's Family Hero Search will fly with up to 4 members of their family for the adventure of a lifetime to China. So send your entry to Mulan's Family Hero Search, P.O. Box 181, South Yarra, Victoria 3141. Entries close on the 8th of May 1999. So good luck!
Mm,
Can I enter?
Oh, you can. You could enter, or maybe we might just be lucky enough that someone takes us to China.
Maybe. Well, where are we taking you after the break?
Well, we're going to check out a science experiment.
Today we'll be learning about biodiversity. What is biodiversity, I hear you ask? Well, biodiversity is life supporting life. It encompasses all the little humans and all the little animals and all the little plants and all the little insects in the world. And we have to keep them all safe and all working together. So, what does this mean, I hear you ask? Well, this means we have to start protecting our environment, starting with you. What can you do, I hear you ask? Well, that is what I am going to show you today. Biodiversity and you. What can you do around your home to improve your biodiversity? Well, let's start in the yard. What you need to do is lock up your pussycat at night so it doesn't eat all the birds and the possums. Then you can plant native trees to your area so the birds come back and nest in the trees. That way you can increase biodiversity in your garden. There are also things that you can do inside the house as well as outside the house to improve our environment. We've already looked at the garden, now we are in the kitchen. Now, firstly, do not leave your tap dripping. What a waste. Do not pour oils and detergents down the sink. They go straight and into the oceans. Remember to recycle and reuse. And once again, do not leave your pussycat outside. He eats the birds. This here is a mound spring found out in the deserts of Australia. Very small supply of water, but feeds lots of little fishes and birdies. So if you were to come along here and destroy this with your cows or with your rubbish, then they would all die, which is not so good. So, that is biodiversity. Kind of like a jigsaw puzzle, isn't it? You take one piece away, you can still see the whole picture. You start taking more than one piece away, and the picture starts to fade. We do not want our puzzle called Earth to fade and disappear, so we must look after it. And that means keeping all the pieces together.
How's your piece going, Mel?
It's all together.
It's a piece of...
It is. Don't touch. That is a very clever idea, you know, because if you did one of these a year, you'd see how much you were growing.
Exactly. Did you put shells in there? This is supposed to be my handprint.
Yes, but as you can see, we have the same size hand. Pretty lucky, hey?
Now, we've just got to make sure that we leave this in the sun for a couple of days so it dries out completely before we put it on the wall.
Oh, and then we can paint it and stuff.
Mm.
Cool, but while we're waiting for this to dry, why don't we head back to Agrabah and see if Iago and Abu can use their brains instead of their vocal cords
to bring themselves back.
Didn't even need to do anything there, there's the look.
Don't touch.
Wouldn't it be cool if you could actually walk through walls? That'd be a skill.
I can.
I didn't think we were supposed to paint this until it was dry.
Well, we're not, but we're breaking the rules.
Oh, right. It's a lovely colour you've chosen. We'll see you after the break.
Thank you.
Then can I have a go?
Yes. Thank
you. What is that all about?
I have no idea.
Well, I'd fly if I had superpowers. Or I'd ask for gills.
Oh, so you could breathe underwater. Now that would be a cool superpower.
Right. I think if I had superpowers, I'd just want to, you know how they get through walls, how they were going, walking through walls?
Would you feel the wall, do you think?
No. Oh, yeah, it would be cool if you did.
You know what I'm hoping? The Aladdin either has some serious superpowers to release his friends, or he could just rub the eye of Gazeem.
Iago is such a feather brain.
He is, isn't he?
Do you think that makes Abu a monkey brain?
An Aladdin brain?
And Genie a genie brain?
I think we need to go to a cartoon.
Absolutely. Here's this week's episode of Winnie the Pooh. It is Tigger's Shoes.